Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the candidate city of Beijing, People's Republic of China, which is bidding to host the Olympic Winter Games 2022.
Dear friends and colleagues, please offer a very warm welcome to the delegation of Beijing. The delegation is led by the Vice Premier of the State Council of the People's Republic of China, Madame Liu Yandong. The President of the Chinese Olympic Committee and Minister of the General Administration of Sport of the People's Republic of China, Mr. Liu Peng. The President of the Beijing Olympic Winter Games Bid Committee and Mayor of Beijing, Mr. Wang Anshun. Ladies and gentlemen, from the delegation of Beijing, the floor is yours.
President Bach, dear colleagues and friends, good morning. On behalf of our country, we are honored to present Beijing's bid and to convey the Chinese people's passion to host the Games in 2022. I would like to begin with a word of thanks to President Bach and my colleagues. Thank you for your leadership and vision, which is manifested in the Agenda 2020. We aspire to authentically embody its principles. Our thanks also go to the Malaysian government and the Malaysian National Olympic Committee for your warm hospitality. And we extend our regards to our friends from Almaty. As every Olympian knows, an honored competitor makes you perform better. Now allow me introduce our team. First, Ms. Liu Yandong, Vice Premier of China. Mr. Liu Peng, President of the Chinese Olympic Committee and the Minister of Sport of China. Mr. Wang Anshun, President of Beijing 2022 and Mayor of Beijing. Ms. Zhang Haidi, President of the National Paralympic Committee of China. Mr. Hou Liang, Mayor of Zhangjiakou. Ms. Yang Lan, Head of Beijing 2022 General Planning and a successful businesswoman. Mr. Zhang Li, Head of Beijing 2022 Venue Planning and Sustainability. Mr. Yao Ming, Olympian and Beijing 2022's tallest ambassador. Ms. Linina, Beijing 2022 ambassador, two-time Olympic medalist, and three-time freestyle aerials world champion. And our two IOC colleagues, Ms. Yang Yang, two-time Olympic champion in short track speed skating. And Ms. Lilian Wei, 13-time world champion in badminton. Chinese President Xi Jinping has met the Beijing 2022 bid national priority. He sends his best regards and greetings to you through this video. He will speak in Chinese.
尊敬的 巴赫
President Thomas Bach, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Chinese government and people, I wish to express to all the IOC members and friends present here our strongest support for Beijing's hosting of the 2022 Olympic Winter Games. The 2022 Olympic Winter Games, if held in China, will boost exchanges and mutual understanding between the Chinese and other civilizations of the world, encourage more than 1.3 billion Chinese to engage in winter sports with interest and passion, and give them yet another opportunity to help advance the Olympic movement and promote the Olympic spirit. The Chinese government highly appreciates the Olympic values and the IOC's initiative of reform. We will honor all the commitments we have made and fully implement the Olympic Agenda 2020. The Chinese people are looking forward to this opportunity. Let me assure you that if you choose Beijing, the Chinese people will present to the world a fantastic, extraordinary, and excellent Olympic Winter Games in Beijing.
China is a longtime friend and loyal partner of the Olympic movement. We created our National Olympic Committee in 1910, sent our first team to the Olympic Games in 1932, successfully organized more than 50 Winter World Cups and championships, and hosted Olympic Games in 2008. You trusted us then, and we delivered on every expectation. Sport was spectacular. We hope you will trust us now to deliver games perfectly aligned with the expectations of IOC and Agenda 2020. We have a saying in China, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. Today, a single historical step in the journey of the Olympic movement will be taken. You have the choice to step forward with a partner who will not only deliver athlete-centered games, but who will also build a foundation for ice and snow sports long into the future. You have the choice to step forward with a city that not only delivers a sustainable games aligned with Agenda 2020, but that also influences a large nation and contributes to the creation of a better world. You have the choice to step forward with a country that not only delivers economical games at the highest level, but that also considers the legacy and the delivery in equal measure. So the impact of hosting lasts many generations. China has been a trusted partner of the Olympic and the Paralympic movements for decades. Beijing 2022 is committed to renewing and extending this partnership and delivering on every expectation. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to invite Mr. Wang Anshun. He will speak in Chinese.
Distinguished President Bach, IOC members and friends, I stand before you today honored to represent my city, Beijing. My history with the Olympic movement goes back to the beginning of preparations for 2008. My core responsibility was to ensure the success of those games and their legacy, a legacy for the city and for the people. The continuing impact can be seen today. Since the IOC began conducting polls in bidding countries, Beijing's bid has recorded the highest ever approval. 92% of our populous nation backs our bid. Sustainability is a national strategy, and the 2008 Games served as an impetus for Beijing to take concrete and far-reaching actions. Beijing is implementing a $130 billion U.S. dollar action plan to enhance air quality. In the past 2 years, we have already reduced coal consumption by 30%, and we have removed more than 1 million high-emission vehicles from our roads. All our efforts are moving Beijing toward a clean energy future. We are committed to making the world better for the next generation. Our successful experience hosting games gives us even more confidence that we can achieve this. Our infrastructure and organizational experience will ensure the best possible end-to-end transport experience from international arrivals and departures to travel among games venues. Beijing Capital International Airport has direct flights from 109 cities worldwide and serves 82.5 million passengers annually. Our second international airport is under construction and will open in 2019. It will nearly double our capacity for arrivals and departures. We will have a well-planned Olympic lane network and active traffic management measures that made our city efficient during previous international events. Rail travel will enable clients to move among venue zones efficiently. In the past decade, China has built the world's largest high-speed rail network. And we add 1,500 kilometers of new track each year. The long-planned link from Beijing to northern China is already under construction. The first leg of this development will move games guests between zones in as little as just 20 minutes. Our transport network and operations will make the games convenient for all games clients. Winter sport will benefit from our infrastructure legacy as we strive to host future World Cups and championships. Beijing is one of the world's top tourist destinations. In 2014, almost 5 million international tourists came to our city. We have more than 110,000 star-rated hotel rooms to welcome business and leisure visitors. We have already signed binding agreements with 132 hotels, exceeding the IOC room requirements by 30%. Rather than adding games risk by building new hotels and media villages, we offer a wide range of existing accommodation. This will give clients greater choice and convenience, and will ensure that all clients enjoy a great games experience. Our ample hotel supply also allows spectators to come in large numbers to celebrate the 2022 Winter Games. Cosmopolitan Beijing awaits all games clients and spectators. Our dynamic, vibrant city has a rich history, amazing culture, and an incredible range of restaurants and shopping for everyone's taste. Ladies and gentlemen, many of you have experienced our Chinese hospitality. And there is another side of China that we hope you will experience, China in winter. China in winter is spectacular. More than half of our country experiences temperatures below freezing. Over millennia, our nation and its people have enjoyed a distinct celebration of winter. We sincerely invite you to come and experience games with the distinct character and flavor of China. Games that are joyful and harmonious. Games that are safe and reliable. I now invite Minister Liu Peng to the podium. He will speak in Chinese. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks to China's previous Olympic Games, we saw a surge in summer sports. Now, winter sport fever is sweeping our nation. There are already 17 ice rinks open year-round in Beijing. More than 1 million teenagers skate regularly. And in winter, our frozen lakes are full of these traditional, rather unique Chinese ice sleds. 20 years ago, China had less than 10 ski resorts. We now have more than 500. Zhang Jiakou alone saw the number of ski trips increase by nearly 20% last year. The tremendous growth in the popularity of winter sport in China ensures real, lasting legacies. In line with Agenda 2020, every Beijing 2022 venue has a realistic and thoughtful post-games legacy plan. 11 of the 12 venues in Beijing are already games legacy venues, substantially reducing costs. And all new venues planned in Yanqing and Zhang Jiakou align with long-term regional development plans. Before we play a film introducing our games master plan, allow me to say a few words about snow. ski resorts have been operating in Zhangjiakou for decades. Consistent with previous games, Beijing 2022 will build on our existing snowmaking capabilities to supplement natural snowfall. Even in its peak operation, our snowmaking system will use less than 1% of the local water supply, with minimal environmental impact. Designed to support our region's master plan for the long-term recreational areas in Zhangjiakou and Yanxing, the system will remain after 2022 for international events and public use. This plan is fully approved by FIS. In fact, every single winter sport IF has approved our plans. We have strong experience in organizing winter sport events, including the Asian Winter Games, Winter Universiade, and many more winter sports world and continental competitions. With support from our IF colleagues and any necessary foreign expertise, our proven event organizing capability will provide a reliable platform for successful Olympic and Paralympic Winter Games. Thank you. And now, here is a look at our master plan.
There is a Chinese proverb that states, everything is well prepared, especially that which is crucial. Our people are prepared for this moment, to create a great Winter Games. The Beijing 2022 Master Plan has three zones connected by a high-speed rail and Olympic lane network, making it efficient for the Olympic family and visitors to travel between zones. As the hub of the Games, the Beijing zone will be the home of the Olympic Park, with the Olympic Village serves as the central point of the Games. Competition venues are immediately adjacent to non-competition venues, accessible and convenient for the Olympic family and visitors. Within close proximity to the Olympic Park are short track speed skating, figure skating, and women's ice hockey venues. Visitors to Beijing will enjoy the ease and convenience of two international airports. A modern high-speed rail system connects the entire Olympic experience like never before. Games guests can board a train near Olympic Park to depart for the nearby Yanqing Zone. The Yanqing Zone is a beautiful mountain setting with all venues located within 10 minutes from the Yanqing Olympic Village. Athletes and guests will celebrate unforgettable moments in these stunning mountains as Olympic history is made. From Yanqing, it's just a short train ride to the third Olympic zone in Zhangjiakou. Zhangjiakou has been a popular winter sport destination for 20 years. The high-speed rail station is in the middle of this zone, delivering visitors right to the doorstep of all venues within 5 minutes. Imagine experiencing the thrill of ski jumping, freestyle skiing, or snowboarding against the dramatic backdrop of alpine scenery and the inspiration of the Great Wall.
Mesdames et messieurs,
ladies and gentlemen, good morning. China offers an incomparable setting for the Olympic winter sports. Our economy comes second worldwide. In 2014, our GDP rose by 7.4%, putting our country amongst the major economies with the greatest growth rate. By 2020, China's GDP and per capita income will have doubled compared with those of the past decade.
And gentlemen, China's economy is robust and resilient. It is not dependent on any one sector. We have our fair share of natural resources and are the world's largest trading partner. All of these factors give our economy diversity and strength to support every commitment that we make. The IOC Evaluation Commission report noted that our OCOC budget is well thought out and presents a viable financial plan. We assure all stakeholders that their interests are not going to be affected by foreign exchange risk. With the guidance of the IOC, our experienced Games team developed a plan that is practical on expenses and conservative on revenues. When Beijing last implemented an Olympic marketing program, we broke many records and generated $1.2 billion in revenues from our domestic partners. Both international and Chinese companies competed for the right to associate with the Olympic Games. Strong marketing success in 2008 sets the stage for us to achieve records for 2022, protecting the long-term financial viability and reputation of the Olympic Games. With the growth of income and the living standards, the purchasing power of Chinese consumers is growing faster than any other major market in the world. Sports and fitness are becoming central to our lifestyle. The sports industry in China is expected to reach $800 billion by 2025. Winter sport in China and abroad will be the long-term beneficiary of this unparalleled growth. An Olympic Winter Games in the Chinese market will create unprecedented opportunities for sport in 2022 and well beyond. Thank you very much. Now it's my great pleasure to hand the floor to Madam Zhang Haidi.
Thank you, Yang Lan. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a breathtaking moment. Along with millions of people with an impairment in China, I'm waiting eagerly for your decision today. 55 years ago, I was paralyzed by spinal disease. Though I will be in a wheelchair all my life, I still feel like I'm running with the athletes. Sport is one of the most important parts of education for young people, especially ice and snow sport, which can ignite their passion and make them stronger. The Games will inspire millions of young people in China to join the fun, skiing on our mountains and skating on our lakes. I recently led the Chinese delegations to both the London and the Sochi Paralympic Games. I see those Paralympians as true heroes, whose spirits inspire the whole world. Beijing 2008 Paralympic Games left great legacies for people with an impairment, bringing greater respect and care. Accessibility advanced by a full generation. More people with an impairment now take part in sport and have been awarded countless medals. The development of sport for people with an impairment is an important priority for the Chinese government, which has invested significant resources in this regard. Both the planning and the delivery of the Olympic and Paralympic Winter Games will be done in parallel. I sincerely wish to welcome you to the 2022 Paralympic Winter Games in Beijing. The Paralympic flame will encourage all people in China with an impairment, inspiring them to overcome their challenges and realize their dreams. I look forward to joining with you the splendid fireworks at the opening ceremony. Thank you.
Every age will produce its own heroes. This proverb embodies the rich tradition of winter sport in China. For thousands of years, winter sports has been an important part of our lives. This lifestyle has been passed down through generations. Our people have embraced the Olympic movement for many years. Producing Olympic heroes. On the ice. On the snow. In the air. And on the podium. Now, these Olympic heroes are passing on what they've learned to a new generation of winter sport fans. Creating a new generation of Olympic heroes. Beijing 2022 will inspire people across China to engage in winter sports, which is a tall order, but China is ready for the challenge. Beijing 2022 will inspire a new generation, and the entire nation is joining in the fun.
Everyone in China is getting into winter sports, including myself. You may not classify basketball as a winter sport. Yes. It is not played on ice or snow, but the basketball season in most of the world takes place during the winter, so you might consider it is a winter sport. In 2008 games, I played with Chinese national team at the Wukesong Arena. In Beijing 2022's plan, Wukesong will host ice hockey. I'm looking forward to see a new chapter in the legacy of the Olympic Games as Wukesong is covered in ice. we may see Song Andong in 2022. Song was born in Beijing and played his first hockey there. He was just drafted by the NHL and he aspired to be our national team, and he needs to show me how to save a gold. Olympians and Paralympians are role models in China. They stir a passion for sports among millions of young people. To tell you more, I'd like to share the podium with my fellow Olympians from Snow and Ice. Ladies, please join me.
Thank you, Yao Ming. It's always a pleasure to stand next to you. Yes, I am standing. Dear President Bach, dear colleagues, Beijing 2022 has made its priority clear. Athletes are the heart of the Games. As an Olympian, I understand the importance of having the best game experience. This means the competition environment is perfect. Enthusiastic fans are plentiful. The village is comfortable, and the training facilities are convenient. Athletes have been involved in our bid since the very beginning. We have worked together with our planning team on all aspects of competition, and will deliver exceptional field of play. China is a sport-loving nation, and you can expect every single seat to be filled with knowledgeable and excited fans. We have committed to expanding sports education in our classrooms, our businesses, and our media to prepare fans who will be among the best ever for all sports. Our concept for Smart Village will put athletes in a new customer-built accommodation that makes them feel at home. China has a long history with Olympic Winter Games. More than 500 athletes have competed as Winter Olympian, and 45 have stood on Winter Games podium, winning 53 medals. The development of Chinese winter sports has paralleled my own story over the past 3 decades. This photo of my teammate, my coach, and me were taken early in my sporting career, which is almost 30 years ago. I was an ordinary girl from a little city in northeastern China, an ordinary girl with an extraordinary passion for skating. My dream was then to become an Olympian, and my dream came true. I was honored to compete in 3 Olympic Winter Games. And today, my dream is to welcome the world athletes to achieve their dreams in my country. Dreams that will inspire more and more children to participate in sports, and including my own. I know I shared this dream with my friend and fellow Olympian, Nina. Nina, please.
Thank you, Yang Yang. I remember growing up, not far from Zhangjiakou, there has been skiing in the region for decades. I was amazed by snow, and when I was 10, skiing became part of my life. I remember the cold winters, training each day to pursue my dream, to climb the slopes, carrying our skis, as there were no ski lifts. China only had 2 aero ski venues back then. Today, I'm happy to see hundreds of young athletes training in over 10 specialized venues. Now, Beijing 2022 will create great legacy venues that will contribute to Olympic winter sports for years. All of the snow sports will see a big boost to training and the leisure activities. The Games come at a magic time in China, Chinese New Year. This is a celebration shared around the world, but it's most special in our home country. Red lanterns line our streets and decorate our doors.
And traditional paper cuts out color our windows and welcome in the visitors.
Families, friends, and their international guests join in reunion dinners.
Lion dancers and parade will fill our street and squares.
And of course, they have more than our share of fireworks. It is an amazing time to visit China. At the peak, all with winter, and the center, all with culture. We welcome you to our home.
And our nation.
Thank you.
In China, we have a saying, the journey is the reward. Every step of our journey will create extraordinary gains set against the backdrop of rich culture, spectacular entertainment, ancient history, and modern amenities.
Now it is my great honor to introduce Ms. Liu Yandong, Vice Premier of China.
President Bach, dear IOC members, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, bonjour. It gives me great pleasure to once again share with you the ardent hope of the Chinese people for hosting the Olympic Winter Games. We would look forward to the Olympic family coming to China in 2022 to enjoy the ice and snow events and the Chinese New Year, and write another shining page in the history of the Olympic movement. On behalf of the government and the people of China, I would like to repeat here our full support for bid of Beijing to host the 2022 Olympic and the Paralympic Winter Games. Now, I will speak in Chinese.
We pledge our full guarantees for the games in the financial, legal, security, organizational, and operational areas. Sport is a noble cause that has the power to change lives and transform the world. The Olympic movement embodies this. China has witnessed the impact that sport has, and we are united with you in purpose to further its growth. Today, winter sports have become increasingly popular among the Chinese people. Hosting the 2022 Olympic Winter Games in Beijing will encourage 300 million Chinese, particularly the country's young people, to participate in ice and snow sports. Together, we will promote winter sports in the world's most populous country. The games will spread a positive and healthy lifestyle, enhance the fitness level of both the young and old alike, and help people to realize their dream for a better life. They will expand the reach of winter sports and bring about new opportunities for further development of the Olympic movement and winter sports. Our bid for Beijing 2022 promotes development and benefits the people. It aligns with the national strategy for the coordinated development of the Beijing-Tianjin-Hebei region and focuses on transport, environment, and economic integration, stimulating tourism and creating jobs. Chinese sport and the Olympic movement have enjoyed a great partnership. We would like to express our heartfelt thanks and our commitment to do more. I am convinced that the vision of the Olympic movement to promote the harmonious development of mankind and build a peaceful world through sport will gain even wider endorsement throughout the world. Ladies and gentlemen, China enjoys political stability, economic prosperity, and social harmony. China is a responsible nation. We shall deliver each and every commitment we have made. We ask for your support.
We ask for your support. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. 谢谢.
Thank you, Vice Premier. The Olympic and the Paralympic Games bring the world together. They create history. They promote the equality and values. They open nations. They are best when they have a purpose beyond the magic of their short days of competition. Beijing 2022 has such a purpose for our nation. We will inspire people to engage in healthy lifestyles in winter as well as summer. For winter sports, we will create unparalleled development opportunities, not just in China. For the world, we will leave a human legacy that will impact generations. Beijing 2022 is a game about the future of winter sport. We hope it will have a future of millions of new fans, a future of new sponsors, partners, a future of new athletes and opportunities. We think about today and know the great responsibility of your decision. We know you are thinking about tomorrow and the great impact your decision will have. I will end our presentation as I began with a Chinese saying, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. On behalf of our people, we ask that you take this step with China and honor us with your vote. A vote will impact generations. With the greatest humility, I ask that you vote for Beijing 2022. 谢谢. Merci. Thank you. This concludes the Beijing 2022 presentation. President Bach, I return the floor to you, and we are ready to answer any questions that you or my colleague may have.
Thank you very much to the delegation of Beijing for an excellent presentation. Now I would like to open the floor for any questions from IOC members, International Winter Sports Federations, and National Olympic Committees. And for this, I pass the floor on to the Director General. Mr. De Keppa, please.
Please, if you have a question, raise your hand. I see Prince Albert. Are there any other questions? I'm looking and I don't see any other question, President.
So, Prince Albert, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. I'd like to congratulate the Beijing team for their presentation. Thank you. Just one small question about if you could expand a little more on your plans for sustainability. There was some reference to it, but if you could please give us a little more information on the sustainability plans. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Prince Albert. Just to check, there are no more questions. Then we close the question time and hand over to the delegation of Beijing to answer the question of Prince Albert, please.
Thank you very much, Your Highness, for the questions on sustainability. I pass the floor to the Mayor of Beijing City, Mr. Wang Anshun, to reply your questions. Mr. Mayor, you have the floor. You are speaking in Chinese.
Thank you. Sustainable development and sustainability is one of the three core concepts in our bid for the 2022 Games. We attach utmost importance to sustainability. The 2022 Games in the Beijing zone will have a total of 12 venues, of which 11 are themselves legacy venues from 2008. The venues that will be newly built will, of course, meet all the demands and needs of the games, but beyond that, will be there to satisfy the growing, strong demand on the part of the public for winter sports facilities. They will be fully utilized post-games. The Beijing 2022 Games plan has already been fully integrated into the national strategy for the coordinated development of the Beijing-Tianjin-Hebei region. Economic development will be highly beneficial, and this strategy and the integration it provides will be highly beneficial for the 2022 Games and for the sustainability of the region as a whole. In addition, we of course stand ready to learn from the good experiences and the best practices of other host cities around the world that have previously hosted games to take on board excellent approaches that they have developed and implemented around sustainability. Our approach will be international, standardized, with robust management methodologies in place to ensure sustainability in all respects, with a strong sustainability management system in order to ensure that the 2022 Games are entirely in line with economic, social, and other aspects of sustainable development. Thank you.
Answered the questions from His Highness Prince Albert. Now I return the floor to you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much once again to the delegation of Beijing. You can be proud of your achievement for your city, region, and country. With your candidature, you have inspired your population and millions of winter sport fans around the world. Thank you for embracing Olympic Agenda 2020. On behalf of the International Olympic Committee, I would like to present you with a diploma to commemorate your excellent contribution to the promotion of the Olympic values. May I invite Vice Premier Madame Liu Yandong to accept this diploma on behalf of the Beijing delegation.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the candidate city presentation for Beijing. Thank you and congratulations.